Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the entrance of our official party. Please remain standing for the invocation given by Chaplain Spencer.
I want you to join me in prayer. Lord God, this morning we thank you for your goodness and your love for us that endures forever. For this truth gives us confidence and hope as we march through all the various seasons and experiences of our lives. Lord, we rejoice and give you thanks for these graduates on this special day of achievement and celebration that marks the beginning of a new season in their lives. Lord, we ask for your blessing on these young men and women who have worked for many difficult weeks and have given so much of themselves to arrive at this much-anticipated moment. Lord, we thank you for their families and all the sacrifices that they have made to make this day possible. We ask that you would fill their hearts with joy as they witness today's graduation as evidence of the fruit of their labor. We also pray that you would grant a sense of accomplishment and pride to the leaders and instructors here at Basic Military Training for their faithful and dedicated service to these graduates. God, grant these airmen strength that they may remain steadfast in the causes of truth, justice, and freedom. And may they always bring honor to the Air Force, to their families, and to themselves. Guard and guide all military members. Give them every success and bring them home safely. All these things we humbly ask in your most holy name. Amen.
Thank you, Chaplain Spencer. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to today's Basic Military Training Graduation Parade. We are honored to introduce our 37th Training Wing Leadership, beginning with the host for today's ceremony. The Commander, 37th Training Wing, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas, Brigadier General Trent H. Edwards, accompanied by his wife, Vanessa. Today's reviewing official is the Commander, Air Force Basic Military Training, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas, Colonel William Fisher, accompanied by his wife, Jane. The Command Chief Master Sergeant, 37th Training Wing, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas, Chief Master Sergeant Sharon Fuller. The Superintendent, Basic Military Training, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas, Chief Master Sergeant Richard Sutherland. We are also honored to have with us several distinguished guests, beginning with the wife of the Commander, Air Education and Training Command, Joint Base San Antonio, Randolph, Texas, Ms. Cheryl Roberson. The Mobilization Assistant to the Director, Legislative Liaison, Office of the Secretary of the Air Force, the Pentagon, Washington, D.C., Brigadier General Ferris Hill. The Command Chief Master Sergeant, Air Education and Training Command, Joint Base San Antonio, Randolph, Texas, Chief Master Sergeant David Staten. The Command Chief Master Sergeant, 2nd Air Force, Keesler Air Force Base, Mississippi, Chief Master Sergeant Farrell Thomas. Would the attendees of the AETC Chief's Orientation Course please stand and be recognized? Although time does not permit us to introduce all of our distinguished guests, this 37th Training Wing is proud to welcome each of you. We hope you enjoy today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, prior to today's ceremony, the military training instructor school class 151208 will receive their campaign hat. The dark blue campaign hat these instructors will receive today has been the symbol of the MTI Corps since 1974. These instructors will carry on the tradition and the esprit de corps of the United States Air Force as they pass on their knowledge to our newest generation of warrior airmen. Technical Sergeant Natalie Sneed. Technical Sergeant Michael Richardson. Technical Sergeant Dustin Bristol. Technical Sergeant Aaron Tarasas. the Distinguished Graduate Award recipient, Technical Sergeant Ronald Eppers. Technical Sergeant Lester Wilson. The Commandant's Award recipient, Technical Sergeant Kelly Bovino. At this time, we ask all MTIs, past and present, to stand in a sign of unity as our graduates recite the MTI pledge.
This is an incredible moment in your professional and personal lives. And I'm so excited that you get to help us at the Gateway Wing build the future of the Air Force. Your pride, your passion, and your professionalism will make the difference in the Air Force that is to come. Your pride in creating an incredible training environment for the men and women of our nation to do great things. Your passion for bringing trainees to standards and creating warrior airmen of character ready to do our nation's business. And your professionalism that will create the standard of what right looks like for the rest of the Air Force. So your pride, passion, and professionalism will carry the day. It will make the difference in our Air Force. And it is you that will ensure that the beginning of everyone's Air Force journey starts out right. I'm so proud of this accomplishment that you've undertaken and how far you've come. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome the newest members of the MTI Corps. Yeah.
Great. present hope.
Thank you, Colonel Fisher.
Order!
The airmen who will pass and review today have completed a demanding 7.5-week program that provides Air Force units throughout the world with trained airmen. Part of this training includes a time-proven concept of military customs and traditions, of which this parade is a vital part. All graduating airmen will also march over the Enlisted Heroes Walk. They will lead the way for the thousands of airmen that will follow, all reflecting on our enlisted heritage, tradition of honor, and our legacy of valor. Our Commander of Airmen is Technical Sergeant Travis Simpson, Military Training Instructor, 322nd Training Squadron. Colonel Fisher will review today's ceremony.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the playing of the national anthem. Thank you. Please be seated. 737 Training Group, United States Air Force, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas. Subject, 2015 Annual Parade Streamer. The first place Annual Parade Streamer is awarded to the 322nd Training Squadron for excellence in parade competition during the period of 1 January through 31 December 2015. Signed, William Fisher, Colonel, United States Air Force. Training Group, United States Air Force, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas. Subject, 2015 Annual Staff Streamer. The first place Annual Staff Streamer is awarded to the 321st Training Squadron for excellence in staff competition during the period of 1 January through 31 December 2015. Signed, William Fisher, Colonel, United States Air Force. Training Group, United States Air Force, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas. Subject, 2015 Fourth Quarter Parade Streamer. The first place parade streamer is awarded to the 321st Training Squadron for excellence in parade competition during the period of 1 October through 31 December 2015. Signed, William Fisher, Colonel, United States Air Force.
Order up!
Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating airmen passing in review today represent a portion of the 38,000 recruits who will complete basic military training this year. The 737 training group provides all recruits the essential military training to become motivated members of the enlisted corps of the greatest Air Force in the world. The military training instructors are responsible for the indoctrination, development, and discipline of the airmen. They have dedicated endless hours to ensure all training objectives are met. Today's graduates have proven through academic study, military training, physical training, and the development of teamwork that they are ready to take place in the United States Air Force. The flights you will review today are representation of the enlisted corps. Each flight represents an enlisted member of the Air Force who has embodied our core values and contributed to its heritage. As our graduates turn left onto the bomb run to pass in review, they will march over the enlisted heroes walk. The airmen recognized on the pavers have been awarded our nation's highest honors, representing heroic and unselfish action as members of the United States Air Force in armed conflict, including present-day operations in Afghanistan. They include 7 Medal of Honor, 26 Air Force Crosses, and 173 Silver Stars awarded for bravery during encounters with hostile enemy combatants. These enlisted heroes serve to inspire all airmen to execute their duties courageously with honor and their service to this great nation. Musical support for this morning's ceremony has been provided by the 737 Training Group's Drum and Bugle Corps, Murray Flight, performing today under the direction of Master Sergeant Samuel Johnson, hometown, Stratford, Connecticut. These airmen are also in basic military training, but have been hand-selected to perform for ceremonies of this type. We would like for you to notice our national, state, and territorial flags. As these flags pass in review, please stand and render the appropriate courtesies for our national flag. Once the flags have passed in review, please be courteous of others and be seated in order to allow all our guests the opportunity to view the flags as they pass in review. Thank you. Cargo Flight, led by Technical Sergeant Christopher Thompson, hometown Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
Hey!
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. Over the last 7.5 weeks, the airmen before you have transformed from civilian into motivated, disciplined warrior airmen with the foundation to serve in the world's greatest air force. Once these airmen leave basic military training, they will enter Airmen Week, where they will develop their critical thinking skills and further personalize the Air Force core values. They will continue on to technical training to learn the skills needed to perform in one of over 130 Air Force specialties. They will then move on to serve at one of over 84 Air Force bases around the world or work directly with our sister services. As these airmen move on to technical training, they will continue to focus on adapting to military requirements, achieving occupational proficiency, and learning how to be highly productive members of the Air Force. These men and women will prepare for increased responsibilities and must ensure they are trained, qualified, and ready to deploy and operate in an expeditionary environment while maintaining home station readiness. Of the hundreds of thousands of airmen, American citizens that enter the workforce each year, less than 1% have joined the ranks of the U.S. military, and an even smaller percentage in the United States Air Force. You should be proud of their accomplishments thus far. The airmen before you have reached a milestone in their Air Force journey and will require your continued support to assist them in their future endeavors. These airmen are the future of our Air Force and will pave the way for future generations of airmen as we continue to fly, fight, and win.
Okay.
We would like to take a moment to congratulate all of our squadron honor graduates as well as their families. Basic military training honor graduates distinguish themselves by being ranked in the top 10% of all airmen graduating in the class. The exceptional personal dedication, energy, service before self, and sustained excellence in earned this way from basic military training earn them this outstanding distinction. As airmen march forward to the ultimate lieutenant, we would like to thank the families and friends who are here in support of the airmen graduating today. Your words of encouragement help motivate the airmen to 7.5 weeks of basic military training. On behalf of the United States Air Force, to the newest airman in the United States Air Force.
last 7.5 weeks, but you chose to be here. You saw the same headlines, and you said to yourself, I'd like to make those headlines sound just a little bit better. I'm so thankful that you've got the courage to do what is hard, to make yourself better, to make your fellow wingmen better. And so I just have one task for you today. Take the core values that we've taught you over the last 7.5 weeks. Take those core values and own them every single day. You will need those core values moving forward to do our nation's business. Those core values are what makes our Air Force great. We are so proud that you've chosen to make this incredible journey that we call the United States Air Force. And at the Gateway Wing in the 737th Training Group, we are so proud to be a part of the start of this amazing journey that we're about ready to launch you on. So really, Airmen, I just have one question for you today. Are you ready to join the ranks of the world's greatest Air Force? Ladies and gentlemen, I think they are ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand. Colonel Fisher will now administer the oath of amendment.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, state your name.
I, Colonel Fisher.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
And that I will obey the orders of the President of the United States.
And I will obey the orders of the President of the United States.
And the orders of the officers appointed over me.
And the orders of the officers appointed over me.
According to regulations and the Uniform Code of Military Justice.
According to regulations and the Uniform Code of Military Justice.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Aaron. Welcome to the world's greatest.
Thank you, Colonel Fisher. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as our newest airmen recite the Airman's Creed and remain in place for the departure of our official party. I am an American airman.
I am a warrior. I have answered my nation's call. I am an American airman. My mission is to fly, fight, and win. I am faithful to a proud heritage, a tradition of honor, and a legacy of valor. I am an American airman. Guardian of freedom and justice, my nation's sword and shield, its ensign and avenger, I defend my country with my life. I am an American airman, wingman, leader, warrior. I will never leave the airman behind. I will never fall.
Thank you. Please be seated.
Thank you.
flights are McCoy and Andrews flights. The next two flights are Harry and Marlow flights. They are followed by Barnes and Gaylor flights. Next are McKinley and Boyd flights, followed by Cody and Matthews flights. The last two flights are Vinegar and Benson flights. Airmen and the city flight mask, Paris flights, will be released to their visitors at the third locker to your left after they secure the flag. Airmen and drop a view of four, Murray flights, will meet their family members at the north side bleachers near the equipped locker after they have secured their exchange service.
All detail trainees report to the blue chair.